This is my worship, this is my offering. In every moment, I withhold nothing. I'm learning to trust you, even when I can't see it. And even in suffering, I have to believe. If you say it's wrong, then I'll say no. If you say release, I'm letting go. If you're in it with me, I'll begin. And when you say to jump, I'm diving in. If you say be still, then I will wait. If you say to trust, I will obey. I don't wanna follow my own ways. I'm done chasing fear. It felt like a burden, but once I could grasp it, you took me further, further than I was asking. And simply to see you, it's worth it all. My life is an altar, let your fire.
Lord, everybody. Amen. Why don't we all stand together, find somebody, greet them, tell them it's good to see them in the house of the Lord. Amen. Brother Boy, it's good to see you. I just saw you come in back there. Good to see you here tonight. Amen. So good to have all of you with us. We're excited tonight. It's going to be a great night of worship and the Word. And then after service tonight, we've already got two people that want to be baptized in Jesus' name, Haley and Landon, and we're excited about that. Heaven's going to be doing some rejoicing. And amen. So I believe we just have a great time together. It's good to have their family with us, Ms. Smith Brown, and then Haley's parent, grandparents. Thank y'all so much for coming and being with us tonight. Amen. But I'm glad to be able to be in the house of the Lord. And the Bible says, enter into his gates with thanksgiving and into his courts with praise. Amen. So we sang about it this morning that it's okay to praise the Lord, that it's all right. Somebody look at your neighbor and say, it's okay to praise God. And you may want to tap your foot a little bit, clap your hands a little bit, or raise your hands a little bit. However you want to praise God, praise is comely in the sight of the Lord, in the house of the Lord. Amen. And we're going to have a great time here together tonight. How many of you know that Jesus is a good God? Amen. That he's a faithful God, that he's able to do exceedingly and abundantly above all that we ask or think. Amen. And I wanted him to know as we start this service, before we sing the first song, amen, I wonder if we can just do what the psalmist said. Can we just enter into his gates with thanksgiving, into his courts with praise? Can we clap our hands and just lift our voices? Come on, can we just magnify him? He said, when the praises go up, my glory is going to come down. Amen. Let's worship him together tonight.
All the time, all the time, you are.
Thank you, Jesus. Come on, the Bible says he's the King of kings and the Lord of lords. And he's worthy. Somebody say he's worthy. Sunday night, and all we got to do is lift up praise to him, and his word says that the glory will come down. He inhabits those praises tonight. Thank you, Jesus.
King of glory, fill this place. I just want to be with you.
Yes.
I just want to be with you.
Glory, fill this place. magnify him, Lord. We'll give you praise, oh God. Give me your praise. Give me your praise. Give
me your praise. Give me your praise. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah. Sing hallelujah.
Just lift our hands. God, I want to be close to you, oh God. Thank you, Jesus.
I just want to be
close to you, Jesus.
I just want to be with you.
Amen. Let's worship him together. Come on, there is a day that's coming where every knee is going to bow and every tongue is going to confess, but I want to get a head start. Amen. I want him to know it's not because you're going to make me one day, God, but as of my choice right now, God, I choose to worship you and I choose to praise you, Lord. God, in this world that we live, it's all ungodly and it's craziness out there, but in your house tonight, God, I've got a choice, Lord, and I choose to worship you, God, because I want to be close to you. Anybody want to be close to him? Amen, amen, amen. Amen. If you want to be close to God, I said it this morning, there is nothing or nobody that can stop you from getting close to him. There's no situation, there's no past that you may have that can keep you from getting close to God. And that's his desire, to be close to each one of us. And his word tells us that as we draw nigh to him, that he will draw nigh unto us. And so if you want to get close to God, look at your neighbor and say, you can get close to God. Amen. Praise the Lord. Remain standing, if you will. Brother Eric Bourne is going to come and bless us with a ministry minute tonight. Amen. Haven't our ministers been doing a great job sharing the word with us in these ministry minutes? And then later tonight, we're going to hear from Brother Brandon and Brother Aaron Lee. I'm excited about that. Amen. But this time, we want to welcome Brother Eric Bourne.
Thank you, Pastor. It's good to see all of you tonight. The Lord is good to us. Pastor, I want to tell you publicly, thank you for jumping the fence and walking all in my pasture this morning. He preached to us this morning, didn't he? We should never be satisfied with being complacent, because complacency is the workplace of Satan. So we should always be careful of that. My text tonight, I've got a lot of scripture, but I'm going to get through it in a hurry, I promise. Ephesians 6, 10 verses 6 verses 10 through 18. Finally, my brethren, be strong in the Lord and in the power of his might. Put on the whole armor of God, that you may be able to stand against the wiles of the devil. For we wrestle not against flesh and blood, but against principalities, against powers, against the rulers of the darkness of this world, against spiritual wickedness in high places. Can anybody say amen? We see that stuff today. Wherefore, take unto you the whole armor of God, that you may be able to withstand in the evil day, and having done all to stand. Verse 14, stand therefore, having your loins girt about with truth, and having on the breastplate of righteousness, and your feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. Above all, taking the shield of faith, wherewith ye shall be able to quench all the fiery darts of the wicked. And take the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, praying always with all prayer and supplication in the Spirit, and watching thereunto with all perseverance and supplication for all saints. You may be seated. So the title that I would use tonight is The Power to Stand. In verse 10, it says to be strong. That means to empower or enable or to increase in strength. The days of battle will destroy us if we're not strong in God. We see that because of the wickedness that we face today. Verse 11, it takes the whole armor of God to stand against the wiles of the devil. The wiles of the devil are cunning arts, deceit, craft, or trickery. Pastor, he would like to trick us in any way that he could. So he don't care how he gets you, just so he gets you. Verse 12, it's not people we wrestle against, but evil spirits. So never think that when somebody comes against you for what you believe or what you stand for, it's them. It's the spirit within them wrestling against that. Verse 13, again, the whole armor of God, to be able to withstand in the evil day, having done all to stand, stand. Verse 14, loins girt about with truth and the breastplate of righteousness. We need a righteous life. Somebody say amen. Verse 15, feet shod with the preparation of the gospel of peace. That peace there means a tranquil state, being assured of salvation through Christ. You can be sure if you have repented of your sins, been baptized in Jesus' name, and received the gift of the Holy Ghost, as long as you keep your hand in His hand, we have assurance of salvation through Christ. Verse 16, above all, the shield of faith to quench the fiery darts of the wicked. That word quench, to suppress or stifle. We have got to have that shield because He is constantly shooting those darts trying to kill the people of God. Verse 17, the helmet of salvation and the sword of the Spirit, which is God's Word. Verse 18, we're to pray in the Spirit with perseverance, which is persistency, a continual battle in prayer. Supplication for all saints. Supplication is simply asking or entreating God for our request. And as Pastor said this morning, to come boldly before the throne of grace. If we are going to stand, it's going to take all of this to endure to the end. Every bit of it. We've got to have the whole armor of God, and we've got to be persistent in prayer and supplication. Matthew 24 and 13, but he that shall endure to the end, the same shall be saved. That word endure, to remain or abide, not recede or flee. It's no time to run, saints. It's time to stay in truth. To continue to fight the good fight of faith and lay hold on eternal life. So it's no time to run. It's time for us to stand and fight. We have the power to stand. God bless you.
Praise the Lord. Aren't you glad that whatever God asks you to do, He'll give you the strength and the ability to do what He's asked you to do? Amen. Thank you, Brother Eric Bourne, for blessing us with that ministry minute. I'm going to make some quick announcements. Amen. And we're going to go right into prayer after these announcements. And so I know there are many needs. Sister Naomi Eaton has requested prayer for her grandfather. We want to lift him up in prayer. And then also Sister Karen had a student, I believe, that graduated a couple of years ago, and his name is Dylan, was involved in an accident, and they had some emergency surgeries they're going to do, and he's going to be another week or more to where they won't know anything of how that's going to turn out, but I believe a prayer made tonight can make a difference. Amen, don't you? Amen. So we want to be considering those needs. Before we go to the Lord in prayer, I do want to make some announcements. Don't forget, this week, a lot of things going on the next week and a half, 2 weeks. And so we want to make sure that you're aware of it. I'll be sure to get on our church family page and make sure to get these announcements on there because there's so much coming up. But this week, the ladies are starting their new Bible study on Tuesday nights via Zoom. And they just did an awesome series in the book, God Has a Waiting Room, and they just finished that up, and they are beginning a new book this week, and so if you haven't already got your book or you need access to that, you can get my wife, Sister Darlise, and they tell you where to get it. I think they've already ordered the ones that they were going to order from the pre-orders, and maybe they got all those passed out this past week, but that's Tuesday night at 7 o'clock, and every Tuesday night at 7 o'clock, and they will begin that this week. Then Wednesday night, we will be back here in the sanctuary. Our adults will be, our youth and children will be upstairs for midweek Bible study and children's church youth service at 7 o'clock. And then Thursday morning, ladies' prayer at 8 a.m. That'll be here in the sanctuary. And again, I mentioned this is a busy weekend. We have our Building the Bridge Conference in Jackson on Friday night and Saturday. And we invite anybody that would like to go down and be a part of that. Brother Dave Henry is going to be speaking. And then our Bible quizzers have a Bible quizzing tournament in Brookhaven Saturday. And then Saturday evening, there is a children's service for those that don't go to Building the Bridge and those children that are still here. The bus is going to be leaving at 5:30 Saturday afternoon, going to Biggersville. That's a Greater Life for a service that begins at 6 o'clock Saturday night, and we invite you to go and be a part of that. And then next Sunday, we have evangelists Jeremy and Jamin Hart going to be with us, and they're going to be blessing us in song. Amen. How many of you just, you like some good singing and you like some good preaching? Amen. You don't want to miss next Sunday morning, Sunday night. We're going to be so blessed by their ministry, and invite somebody to come and be with you, and you will be blessed, I promise you. And then, as a reminder, we do need some candy turned in for Easter eggs that we're going to be doing. We're going to be having our annual Easter egg hunt. That's Easter Sunday, which is just right around the corner, the first Sunday in April. And we're going to have a great time together, but we do need candy. I've got about 700 plastic eggs that we need to put some candy in. And so I appreciate in advance all that you're going to be doing for that. Our youth are doing a fundraiser this Easter. And I believe there is a limit on how many of these they're going to do. I think 10 or 10. I think they're doing 10. So the first 10 that sign up, they are doing Egg Your Yard for you. And it's not with raw eggs, because we don't do that anymore. We done grown up. But praise God, it's going to be with candy-filled eggs. And so you can get 30 eggs for $25 or 50 eggs for $45. And so if you're going to have a Easter egg hunt at your home for the children or grandchildren, just get in touch with Brother Tyler, Sister Katie, and they'll come do your eggs for you. And the first 10 people that sign up is going to have access to that. And so thank you. They are getting money together to go youth congresses this year. And so they are raising money, trying to get everything prepared for that. So if you can help them, if you'd like to make a donation to that, feel free to do so. And then looking ahead, we do have a community Easter egg hunt at Plum Rose Park, which used to be Westside Park. And they are just almost done with that new playground. I don't know if you've been by there lately, but it looks awesome. And I can't wait to get on that little spider net. And maybe I won't break anything, but I'm going to get out there and play on that thing if they don't have a weight limit. If they don't have a big sign up that says, must be, you know, whenever I was a kid, the height thing never worked. I always had to go by the weight. And, y'all know the feeling, but I've been big boned all my life. And so, praise God. But there is a community Easter egg hunt from 10 to 12 on March the 27th. That's a Saturday. That following Sunday at 10 a.m., we have Baby Dedication Sunday, and that's on March the 28th at 10 a.m., and then that afternoon at 4 o'clock, from 4 to 7, I misread that this morning, from 4 o'clock to 7 o'clock, we're going to be having a shrimp and crawfish bowl. Amen. I'm excited about that, and we're going to have a great time together and fellowshipping and playing games and just coming and say, I don't like those things of the sea. I don't like those things that you find in a ditch somewhere. Come out and fellowship with us and have a good time. We'll have other stuff here. We are asking that you bring a side and dessert. We'll have tea and water and all the shrimp and crawfish and corn on the cob and Brussels sprouts and mushrooms. And y'all feel the Spirit of the Lord moving, don't you? Amen. I feel expectancy in the house tonight. Praise God. But do remember that. And then April the 1st, Section 1 Kids Rally, that's Thursday night at 7 o'clock on April the 1st at the Central Church in Corinth. Brother Kevin Merriman, the children evangelist, is going to be there. You don't want to miss that. You want to, don't just send the children. Come with your kids. Come with your grandkids. Let's go and let's have a great time. Amen. There's always young people just giving their hearts to God, and God's filling them with the Holy Ghost, and God's doing a great work in this next generation. And so let's not just have to come back that Sunday and hear about it. Let's go and see it. Let's go see God do a work in this next generation. Amen. Let's all stand, if you will. We're going to go to the Lord in prayer. And I know there are many, many needs. Again, I've already mentioned those. Others, Sister Naomi texted me. Her grandfather's name is Alvis Durham, and so we definitely want to lift him up in prayer. And Dylan Davis is that young man that's in the hospital. And we want to just continue believing for that family, that God would touch him also. Sister Karen Allen's uncle had to be rushed to surgery today. And they went to do surgery. And because of some blood thinners he was on, they had to hold off. And so he's just in real critical condition right now, but needs open heart surgery. We want to pray that God would touch him and to move in his life. He's a bad diabetic, But God can touch his diabetes and help him with this. Amen. We still serve a healing God. What God, what we read about in Scripture is not something that stopped. It's still going. Amen. He's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And we thank him for that. Continue praying for Sister Ruth, Sister Catherine, their family. Sister Anita, as I mentioned this morning, she's going to be going home this week, and she's still got a long road. Amen. But God's been doing so much in her life, and we thank God for that. So continue praying for her. Sister Faye Wallace, we want to continue lifting her up in prayer. Brother Randy Henry had texted this morning. He wasn't feeling well. We'll lift him up in prayer. Amen. Continue praying for our elders that can't come to church in a nursing home. We want to pray for Sister Isabel. Amen. Pray for Sister Cook that God would touch them. Amen. Continue praying for Brother Johnny Lindley. We know he'd be here if he could, but we want to pray that God would strengthen him, touch his body in a great, great way. Sister Elena, she was able to be here this morning, but we want to pray that God would continue to. Sister Lindley, I just saw you back there. Amen. Good to see you. We're praying for Brother Lindley. Amen. God's good, and he's going to touch him tonight in Jesus' name. Amen. If you have an unspoken request, would you just make it known by the lifting of your hand? Amen. God knows what your need is. Amen. If you feel you want to come up for prayer, the Bible says that call for the elders of the church. It didn't say for the elders to come to you, but if you want special prayer, we'll pray the prayer of faith. The prayer of faith can save the sick. Amen. We believe that. And so I want to encourage you tonight. Let's believe God for these needs. God, we love you so much. Thank you, Lord, for your presence that we feel in the sanctuary tonight. I pray, Lord, that you would continue to reach down, continue to draw us, continue to convict us. God, as we praise you, as we continue to sing song to you, God, help us to know, Lord, that you are truly the healer. God, that by your stripes we are healed, Lord. Continue to give peace and comfort to these families that have lost loved ones, God. Minister to them, God. Touch Sister Anita. Continue to do a work in her body. Thank you for what you've brought her to. But, Lord, we know that what you've begun, that you will perform until that time. God, I pray you would continue to do that. Touch Sister Faye tonight, God. Minister to her body, God. Give her strength, God. Take away that pain, oh, God. I pray, Lord, you would touch Sister Elaine tonight. Take that pain out of her back tonight. In the name of Jesus, we trust you and thank you. And somebody say, in Jesus' name, amen. I like this song right here. We're gonna go a little Southern gospel tonight. I like Southern gospel music. You get in my truck, you got the eagle. We flying high. Amen. But I love that stuff. But this song is the master of the wind. And I'm glad I know the master of the wind, aren't you? Let's sing this together. Know him tonight.
I know the master of the wind. I know the maker of the rain. He can calm the storm, make the sun shine again. I know the master of the
among the peaks my soul can be found. When an unexpected storm can drive me from the highs, it may bring me low, but it will never bring me down.
Aren't you thankful you can testify of that?
I know the master of the wind.
Among the peaks my soul can be found.
We don't like when this happens though.
An unexpected storm can drive me from,
but with the understanding it can bring me low, but it
But if you don't know Him, you can know Him tonight. Thank you, Jesus.
I know the Maker of the rain. He can calm the storm,
make the sun shine again.
I know the Master of the wind.
Can we just lift our hands and thank Him?
I know the Master of the wind. I know the Maker of the rain. He can calm the storm,
make the sun shine again.
I know the Master of the wind.
Sometimes I soar like an eagle to the skies. Among the peaks my soul can be. From the high, it may bring me low, but it will never bring me down. And this is why
I know the Master of the wind.
Oh yes,
I know the Maker of the rain. He can calm the storm.
Love on Him for a moment. Thank you, Jesus. Amen, amen. Anybody glad you know who Jesus is? Amen. It doesn't matter where in life that life has brought you. It doesn't matter what the winds of life have done to you and where they've placed you. The disciples were in the boat with Jesus, and Jesus said, let us go to the other side. And the winds were boisterous, and the waves were getting crazy. And they was getting fearful, and because, you know, storms are real, and they have a way of making you think about things. And amen. I know as a church, we're looking forward to the days coming back for us. But in reality, I'm glad we got a little bit of time to work and to, amen, and to make a difference on the earth. And those disciples had all that stuff around them, and Jesus had to go get him up, and he just said, you know what, I'll tell you what, I'm not even going to play now. I'm just going to step out on the bow of the ship. And he said, peace, be still. And Brother Magruder, a long time ago, they were doing a concert at Fulton at ICC campus. And I'll never forget this. I was a young man and barely old enough to drive, and I went up to that concert, and Brother Magruder, y'all remember the Magruders? He got up there, and they were about to sing a song, Sister Magruder was, and he said this, and I'll never forget, and I've used it, I've preached it, but it was good. But I'm not an English major, and Sister Karen's not here tonight, but the way that it's written in the Bible is, it says, peace, comma, be still. And what those disciples looked at, they saw that, and it was just a storm. The winds and the waves were all crazy. And what they saw is a big storm, and that's what they called it. Hey, Lord, the storm is upon us. The Lord looked out at it, and he said, peace. What they thought was there to destroy them, the Lord already had a name for it. And so sometimes we may look at things in life and we can't see peace in it. And we can't see the provision of God in it. And we can't see how God can ever work on our behalf in that situation. But if you will just get Jesus up and put him in the front of your life and just say, God, I want you to take control of this thing. Now, I've been rowing and I've been trying to get to the other side with you in the back of the boat. But now, God, I want you to step to the front of this thing. Amen. God can turn a bad situation into something great for you. So if you really want the peace of God in your life, amen, give God a chance to speak to some things. Amen. Peace be still. I'll never forget that. Amen. We're going to sing this song before we get these ministers up here to preach to us.
And you have to be standing for this song. I just don't know if I can sit down for this one. It says, I'm just warming up. You might even have to get out in the aisle a little bit and just kind of give yourself some room and say, okay, God, the word's coming in a minute, so I'm going to just warm up for the word. Amen. What are you doing? I'm just warming up for the word. Amen. Before we go over here and we work out and we do all that stuff, and I know you can tell it's been a little while since I've done that, but it's dangerous to get out there and do some work without warming up. You'll hurt something. You'll pull something. And that same thing's true in the church. Amen. You need to go ahead and just warm up tonight to what the Lord wants to speak into you. Amen. And just make up your mind. God, I'm going to let you talk to me tonight. Amen. My wife got me all these things tonight, and my voice ain't going to hold in here, but we're going to have a good time. And I do. I challenge you. Maybe get out. Maybe if you want to take a moment. I tell you what, ushers, come on up here. We ain't taking up an offering yet. My goodness. Can't come to a church service without taking up an offering. Amen. I want you to be blessed. But we're going to do it this way. We're going to have those ushers come up here, and we're going to give everybody a chance to just kind of walk around. Even if you're not giving in the offering, walk around in faith that God's going to give you something to give. Amen. And just go ahead and fellowship for a moment, and we're going to have a good time as we prepare for the word right here. So everybody just, amen. God, I want you to bless this offering. God, bless those, Lord, that are able to give. Lord, those that are being faithful as your word commands us. I pray, Lord, that you would open up the windows of heaven and pour them out blessings that they don't have room to contain. Lord, bless those that are seeking after you, Lord, because your word says you're a rewarder of them that diligently seek you. God, in every area of our life, God, help us to seek you with our whole heart. In Jesus' name, the church said amen. Amen. Let's get out a little bit, make some little laps, if you will, and warm up for what the Lord wants to do in his word. We'll find somebody you hadn't talked to in a little while. Well, I went to visit a church, and it was quiet as it could be. There was nobody praising the Lord, nobody but me. They said I was emotional, you know, I kind of felt out of place. But when I come to church, I don't just come to take up space. 'Cause I'm just warming up. Oh, I'm just warming up.
up.
I'm just warm enough without cheating in the sky.
So if you think I'm strange, don't sit around and wait for me to change.
I'm just warm enough when I reach the other side.
My goodness. Praise the Lord. I tell you a good way, you know, you gave in y'all tonight. This morning we talked about let everything that hath breath praise the Lord. When you praise Him, do you just ain't got no more breath? Okay, God, I've given it all. Amen. I'm telling you, there is a presence of the Lord is in this place. Amen. I'm ready to see what the Lord wants to do in His Word, aren't you? Amen. Brother Brandon Lambert, I want you to come share with us the Word tonight. And then Brother Aaron Lee is going to be following him. We got some tag team preaching going on. And last week, what a great presence of the Lord that was in this place Sunday morning, Sunday night. Then again this week, just a great time. It's what happens in this last days. He said, I'm going to pour out my Spirit upon all flesh. And I just believe it. I mean, that's what His Word said. And who am I to think anything different? So if you need the Holy Ghost, you never received the Spirit of God with the evidence of speaking with other tongues. I just believe that tonight could be your night. And just, yes. It's no big thing for God. Amen. He wants to. That's His promise. Amen. Brother Brandon, I want you to come. Take your liberty. Amen. Let's see what the Lord wants to speak to us tonight.
Get the desk situated here. Sweet presence of the Lord in the house tonight, isn't it? Amen. I want to thank Pastor for allowing the opportunity to be able to minister in this place tonight. Amen. I'm just thankful that we were all able together tonight in the house of the Lord. Amen. To feel what we feel that is stirring in the atmosphere. These couple that is getting baptized tonight, man, that's just awesome. That's a good way to start 2021 off, right? Amen. And anybody else who wants to get baptized tonight, I'm sure it's all right. Amen. Amen. And prayer and fasting, I feel that the Lord pressed upon my heart a small word. I'm not going to try to take up too much time. Amen. But I do feel like pretty heavy in my spirit. By what I want to deliver tonight, amen. I believe that if somebody can leave changed, if one person can leave here different than the way that you came in here, that's all I'm worried about, amen. And I think that's all the church is worried about, amen. We just come in here and feast off the Word, feast off the Spirit of the Lord, amen. And see what the Lord wants to do in this place tonight in our hearts. Amen. I want to take my scripture text from Exodus chapter 14. And I'm not going to have a whole lot of scripture as far as I've got a couple places I want to go. And this is one of them where I want to take my scripture text to. Amen. I've been weighed pretty heavy the past few days with this on my mind. And I just want to deliver to you what I feel I got in my heart. And I just want to let the Lord have His way. And I want you to let the Lord have His way if He's ministering to you. If He's ministering to you in your heart and in your life, respond. Because it's all about Him. Our righteousness is His filthy rags. Amen. We are in this place to please Him. And He's ultimate. Exodus chapter 14, verse 15 and 16. It says, and the Lord said unto Moses, wherefore criest thou unto me? And He says, speak unto the children of Israel. And this last part of this scripture is where it falls for me. That they go forward, but lift thou up thy rod, he's talking to Moses, and stretch out thine hand over the sea, and divide it. And the children of Israel shall go on dry ground through the midst of the sea. I just pray the Lord would touch our minds and our hearts tonight. Could we lift the Lord up right now? Lord, I prayed right now. Lord, I know that you didn't let this weigh heavy in my spirit and my mind. Lord, after this morning service, our pastor preaching such a message to us, Lord, going home and working and getting my mind upon the day and the night, Lord, I know that you're going to minister to just one person, Lord. I don't know who they are, but I feel it, and I know it in my spirit, Lord, and I pray that your word would lay gently in their spirit and that they would leave this place changed and we would give you the glory and the honor for it in the mighty, mighty name of Jesus. And you can be seated. The title of the message is Deliverance is in the Forward. Deliverance is in the Forward. And I draw my thought from the conclusions of the word of the Lord in the scripture text in which I had delivered unto you just a moment ago. We're reading about a particular place in the scripture where the children of the Lord, Israel, they were in bondage in a place of affliction in Egypt. They had been there for 430 years in Egypt, where they had been suppressed and depressed, worked over and enslaved by the Pharaoh. My thought is sometimes we find our place too far long into a certain location. As the children of Israel, they were in Egypt. They were there for far too long. But the Lord had begun to work in their lives even under suppression. And I believe that sometimes in your spirit and in your heart, you find your place sitting there as if you have no place to go. And you do not know what that you're going to do. But I want you to know tonight, before that you leave here, just as the children of Israel spent 430 years too long in the state of mind and suppression, that you do not have to do that, because you can leave this place delivered. I believe that with all of my heart, that deliverance is in the house tonight. He has come into this place to set you free. As the word of the Lord said, Jesus said he came to preach to set those captive free. He came to set them at liberty that were bruised. And tonight, it is no different for you. They spent all this time of 430 years, and I'm sure that it wasn't all into a bad situation, but it gradually grew into that place. And the Lord began to work on their behalf. And I want to move along in the scripture because I don't want to spend too much time. I'm trying to really cram all that I feel in my spirit. But they faced a time where the Lord was wanting to release them, and he was working on their behalf, even though that he looked down upon them in the state of their slavery. The Lord said that it was past time for them to be set free. But the Pharaoh that he had, Lord wants to deliver you from whatever you are suppressed under tonight before you leave this house tonight. It's not the will of the Lord for the children of God. And when I say that, I mean for Israel and for you and I to be born again of the water and of the Spirit, baptized in Jesus' name, for us to live in the state of mind where we are under suppression. The children of Israel, they begin to see the Lord work in the 10 plagues that rested upon Egypt. And they seen the mighty hand of God work time and time again on their behalf. You yourself, you may have even seen in your past, in the times that you went through mighty, mighty big trials, that the Lord, He had intervened on your behalf time and time again. The Lord is for you. The Lord is on your side. I want you to know, if you ever get that in your spirit, that if you ever really know and grasp that the God of this world, the God that created heaven and earth, that breathed air into our lungs, that spoke peace to the storm, that created the man that you and I are, and the women and the boys and girls that you and I are, out of the dust of this earth, if we could ever understand that He is before us, who can be against us? That weeping may endure for the night, but the joy, it cometh in the morning. I said there's deliverance in the house. The Lord bringing Israel to a place where He was about to set them free. And I want you to know, you may feel like you have been 430 years in the state of a situation that you're in, and that you need God to deliver you and to set you free. There's no better time. There's no better situation. There's no better church service. Don't wait for next week. Don't wait for things to think that it's about to get better. Give it unto the Lord tonight. Don't leave this place in bondage. Let the Lord deliver you, and let Him set you free. Let Him heal you. Let Him heal you. My Lord, I tell you what, I know the Lord, He is working in our midst tonight. As the Lord was working in the midst for the children of Israel, as He began to work on their behalf and set them free and deliver them from the place that they were at, the Lord sent them in the way of the wilderness, out of the way of the Philistines. Because He said, unless they were captured with fear and seen that war was before them, that they would not be ready to face the battle. So the Lord sent them in the way of the wilderness. He had to send them into a way that they would not look back, that their total dependency would be upon Him. Sometimes we face those things in our lives that we begin to be more dependent upon ourselves than we are upon God. And the Lord has to intervene and send us in the direction to bring us back in to Him. The Lord worked on their behalf. He delivered them out of bondage. And in the midst of the wilderness, the Pharaoh and his army followed them after the last plague plagued the Egyptians by taking the oldest of all of the men and all the animals and everything. The Lord knew that it would get His attention and that He would send them on their way. He was letting them know that He was on their side. It's amazing that it took 430 years for them to actually find that place to where that they were sensitive and seasoned enough in their spirit to let the Lord work on their behalf, that the Lord set them free. They went into the wilderness, and the Pharaoh and his army began to follow them in. And the scripture said they went into the wilderness, and Pharaoh followed them in into a place where he thought that he had them snookered, if you please, into a place where they couldn't get out of the wilderness. But it was along the sea where the Lord was going to set them free. It was along the sea where the Lord was going to open the sea up for a big deliverance. And in the scripture text that I read tonight, right here, it said that, "And the Lord said unto Moses, Wherefore criest thou unto me, speak unto the children of Israel, that they go forward." after all the Lord had delivered them from up until this point, that there was not a full deliverance until they fully moved forward across the sea. And the Lord breathed upon that sea and spread the water. And they were able to move across into their place of deliverance. There's deliverance in the house. There's deliverance for you. There's deliverance for your life. Deliverance for situations that you may be facing right now. I believe the Lord wants to work on your behalf. Please don't leave this place till you have fully let go and let God deliver you from the things, from whatever that it is that you're dealing with. Amen? Don't let yourself leave this place. This is a place of safety. Amen? Could we love Him right now? Lord, we thank You, Jesus. Come on, He wants to restore a song into your life of deliverance, of happiness, and joy. Amen. He wants us to move forward. Amen. Praise the Lord. Can we give the Lord a good hand clap of praise? The Lord knows. He knows where we are. And He is for us. Amen. If He is for us, I promise you, there's no Pharaoh. There's no suppressive device. There's no devil that can come against you and be successful if you trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not onto your own understanding. Can we love Him right now? Thank you.
Somebody say deliverance is in the forward. Amen. That's one thing to get assembled. And I loved, one part I loved about the military was getting in formation. And there's nothing more beautiful to me than seeing 100-plus soldiers just get in a group where they're lined up, dress right, dress, and just a perfect formation. That's just a beautiful sight to me, to be in step, to be in formation. But the deliverance and the victory comes after the command is given for forward march. Amen. That's whenever you really see what happened, the result of that formation that happens. So I believe that God's calling us, and what Brother Brandon talked to us about tonight, I believe God's calling us to hear the voice of the Lord to say, forward march. God's been forming some things. He's been getting us to put a hand in front of you to decide, to make sure we're all lined up. Amen. But He's ready to send us out into this world and this community to see a great revival in this end time hour. And I don't know about you, but I'm ready to go forward. I'm ready to see what the Lord wants to do in us and through us. Amen. Brother Aaron Lee, come. Take your liberty. Everybody say, God bless Brother Aaron.
I want to start off by thanking Pastor for giving me this opportunity. Got a little maybe unorthodox message tonight. Don't get worried. I know I'm following two great men of God. Brother Soden preached this morning about further faith, and Brother Eric preached about the power to stand, and Brother Brandon just talked about moving forward. And I want to start by, of course, reading my scripture title tonight, which is going to be Proverbs 27 and 17. It's a very short passage of scripture. It just says, iron sharpeneth iron, so a man sharpeneth the countenance of his friend. And you may be seated. In 1995, a movie was released that formed cinema history. A story of two rivals, through their envying and trickery, find themselves lost in a strange land. It doesn't take long for our unlikely pair to learn that they need to set aside their differences to find their way back home. They find themselves traveling many miles and overcoming many obstacles, facing Frankenstein-esque creations and even escaping an intense and deadly interrogation. Our heroes overcame all this, and finally they find themselves back where they belong. They find themselves back home. And for those of you who may be wondering, yes, I am talking about Disney Pixar's Toy Story. You see, when this movie begins, as the credits begin to roll and tell you the big stars that are in the movie, the team that worked on it, there's a song that plays, and it's You've Got a... All right. So tonight, my title is You've Got a Friend in Me. So what happens when our faith doesn't feel like it can move further? What happens when it feels like we don't have the power to stand? What happens when it likes our strength fails and we can't move forward? Brother Brandon, we have to remember, you've got a friend in me. I want you to look at your neighbor and say, you've got a friend in me. If I were to ask any of you in this room to raise your hand, I'm not going to. If you had ever experienced loneliness, you would probably... there probably wouldn't be a hand down in the building. Loneliness is a very dangerous thing. Just for an example, during the pandemic of the previous year, suicide rates in Cook County, Illinois had increased by 13% higher than the previous year. And if you think that's rough, places such as Fresno, California saw a spike of up to 70%. The National Alliance on Mental Illness saw a 65% increase in calls and emails for suicide prevention. Loneliness is a dangerous place. But you see, I'm here to tell you today that there is hope for us in our loneliness. You see, Proverbs 18 and 24 tells us, a man that hath friends must show himself friendly, and there is a friend that sticketh closer than a brother. We were not made to be lonely. The whole creation of man was built for God to have a friend. God created Adam in the garden, but then when he saw that Adam became lonely, he created Eve. However, so many of us easily find ourselves in a place that we feel loneliness. We can be in a room crowded by people. People you know love you, people you know who care for you, and you can still feel alone. But we're not alone in feeling alone. Surely David felt some form of loneliness after he was anointed to be king and then put back in the field by himself with the sheep. Surely Joseph felt a bit of loneliness after being betrayed by his brothers, who then faked his death to his father and sold him into slavery. Surely Job felt lonely after he lost everything he had and the people closest to him told him to curse God. But you see, when God stepped in, he turned that loneliness into blessing. David was appointed king and then noted as a man after God's own heart and then placed in the lineage of Jesus Christ. Joseph was placed in a position of power and was able to provide for his family during a famine. Job was given an abundance more than he had before. And if you think your season of loneliness is meant to destroy you, I'm here to tell you that's meant to strengthen you. You see your brother, you see your sister, you're feeling lonely. My scripture text said, iron sharpeneth iron. Iron's not a soft thing. It takes something just as hard. If you're lonely, who else to fix it other than someone who's felt pretty lonely? Each of these situations changed to victory. Whether by plan or by faith, God can turn your lowest place into your greatest victory. See, Hebrews chapter 10, verse 24 says, "And let us consider one another to provoke unto love and unto good works." Good stuff. Not forsaking the assembling of ourselves together as the manner of some is. Don't shut yourself off from the church. It's the number one mistake. If the enemy can get you separated from like-minded people, godly-minded people, he can shut you off from every bit of repair every bit of progress you have made. As the manner of some is, but exhorting one another, lifting each other up, and so much the more as you see the day approaching. The day is approaching, and it is approaching faster than it ever has before. And if you don't know what I'm talking about the rapture, when Jesus Christ is coming back. It is more important to us now more than ever that we come together and encourage each other and support each other, lift each other up. If you see your brother and sister is in need, do something to help them. It's not hard. Sometimes it's just a simple, are you okay? Can be the biggest lift up in somebody's day. If they can go ahead and come back to the music. One of the best examples of this is in Mark chapter 4, where we find four men who are trying to get their friend who was sick of the palsy to Jesus, who was teaching. And it says the press, the crowd, was so thick that they could not get through. So it would make pretty decent sense that these men just packed up and went home. Jesus will be somewhere else some other time. We can bring him to him then. But you see, these four men had a different idea. These four men took their faith further. They decided to stand, and they decided to move forward, and they said, it's not good enough to wait another day. They said, today. And they tore the roof, they dug the roof, and they lowered this man down, and he was healed. But you know, it's really interesting what the Bible says, because it says when Jesus saw their faith. It doesn't say when he saw the man's faith. It says their faith. So it wasn't a solo act of faith that gave this man his healing. It was the combination of four men who said, not today. My brother's sick. My brother's down. I'm going to lift him up. I'm going to take him. I'm going to go. Whether he can't or he won't, I'm going to go. God can move through others' faith for you, or he can move through your faith for others. So tonight, if it's appropriate, if you're comfortable with it, I want you to find somebody. Brother, find a brother. Sister, find a sister. And I want you to pray with them. And I don't mean just a prayer. I want you to pray over their life. I want you to pray over their well-being. I want you to pray over their finances. I want you to pray blessing on them like you've never prayed a blessing on anybody in your life. Because who is in this building is who we have. We are workers together. And I'm telling you, if we unify, if we find this strength together, if we work for the kingdom together, then this city is not going to stand a chance. Nothing in this city that is standing against God's work is going to stand a chance. Thank you, Jesus.
You're my brother, you're my sister, so take me by the hand. Together we will work until he comes. There's no foe that can defeat us. We're walking side by side as long as there is love.
Come on, we can do it together.
There is no foe that can defeat us when we're walking side by side. As long as there is love, we will stay.
I want to agree with that brother. Agree with that sister. You don't have to do this by yourself. Come on, that loneliness is just a feeling. It's not a reality as much as the enemy wants to make it seem real to you. We are never alone. But we've always got a friend that's sticking closer than a brother. He's always there. Now we're trusting you, Lord. It's your word. I'm going to trust your word more than I trust the voice of the enemy in my life. God, as long as, Lord, we've got our brother, as long as we've got our sister, as long as we've got you, oh God.
You're my brother.
Can we just sing that tonight?
So take me by the hand. Together we will work until he comes. There's no foe that can defeat us. We're walking side by side. As long
Amen.
As there is love,
oh, we will stand.
Will stand.
Thank you, Jesus. Amen. We're going to baptize Haley and Landon in a moment. Have you enjoyed being at church tonight? Amen. What a just a sweet presence of the Lord that's here. And I'm so proud of Haley and Landon and what God's doing in their life. And y'all be so proud of them. Y'all, I know y'all are, but just coming up and praying in the altar.